In part one of our lesson on trig equations with multiple angles, you will learn a method for finding all possible solutions. We will use these four steps when we are solving trig equations to find all the infinitely many possible solutions that they have. First, we'll isolate the trig function using the trig identities and/or algebra. Second, we'll determine the possible quadrants and make a sketch. Third, we'll find the reference angle and use it to label the angle solutions on your drawing. And fourth, we'll find the formulas for all possible solutions by solving one of these equations. If we are in radians, you will take the argument of your trig function and set it equal to the angle plus 2n pi. Or if you are in degrees, you will take the argument of your trig function and set it equal to the angle plus 360 degrees times n. So let's see how this works in this first example where we have to solve 2 sine of 3x plus radical 3 is equal to 0 for all radian solutions. So what I've done on this first example is write in the step that we're going to be using so you can see how we're working our way through the four steps. In step one, we have to isolate the trig function. So here we see we will subtract radical 3 from both sides. So now we have 2 sine of 3x is equal to negative radical 3. And then we will divide both sides by 2 to get sine of 3x is equal to negative radical 3 over 2. So that's step one, where we isolate the trig function. In step two, we have to determine the possible quadrants and make a sketch. Because the sine of 3x is negative, we know that means we are going to have to be in quadrant 3 and quadrant 4. Next, we have to find the reference angle and use it to label the angle solutions on our drawing. Because the sine of 3x is negative radical 3 over 2, we know that we look on our special angle chart, and that tells us that theta r is going to be pi over 3. So we label pi over 3 on our drawing as the reference angle in both quadrants 3 and 4. And now we will use that reference angle to say that we know if we're here at pi and we go pi over 3 more, that we will have to be at 4 pi over 3. So that's one of the solutions. If we come over here to quadrant 4, we would start at 2 pi, and we would back up by pi over 3, which puts us at 5 pi over 3. That's the other solution. Next, we will find the formulas for all the possible solutions by solving the equations where we set the argument of our function equal to the angles that we found plus 2n pi. So the argument of our function is 3x, so we're going to take 3x and set it equal to the first angle that we found, 4 pi over 3 plus 2n pi. Or we solve a second equation where we take the argument of our function, again, 3x, and we set it equal to the other angle we got, 5 pi over 3 plus 2n pi. So we solve these equations for x. Let's start with this first one. My recommendation to you will be to get a common denominator on the right-hand side. We see that that denominator would be 3, so really what's happening is we're multiplying the 2n pi by 3 over 3, so the right-hand side has a denominator of 3, and the numerator becomes 4 pi plus 6n pi. The left-hand side is still 3x. Now we need to get the x by itself, so we will multiply both sides by 1/3, and we get that x is equal to 4 pi plus 6n pi over 9. And that is one of the formulas for all the solutions. We're going to do the same thing over here for this second equation. Our common denominator on the right-hand side is going to be 3. So we multiply 2n pi by 1 in the form of 3 over 3. Our common denominator is 3. The numerator becomes 5 pi plus 6n pi. On the left-hand side, we have 3x. Once again, we will multiply each side by 1/3, and we end up with x is equal to 5 pi plus 6n pi over 9. And that is the second formula, which finds all the solutions. Both of these formulas are necessary to find all the possible solutions to this equation where we ended up with sine of 3x is equal to negative root 3 over 2. These two formulas will generate all the infinitely many solutions that that equation has. In this next example, we have to find all possible radian solutions to the equation 2 cosine of 4x is equal to radical 2. So remember that step 1 was to isolate the trig function. We can see all we have to do here is divide both sides by 2. So now we have cosine of 4x is radical 2 over 2. We know the second step is to make our drawing. So we know that the cosine of 4x is positive. So that means we are going to be in quadrants 1 and 4. We use our special angle chart. We go in the cosine row, look for the value of radical 2 over 2, and we get that theta r is going to be pi over 4. We put the reference angle in quadrant 1, we get pi over 4. If we put the reference angle in quadrant 4, we have to do 2 pi minus pi over 4 is 7 pi over 4. Next, we will take the argument of our function and put it in an equation So we take 4x has to equal pi over 4 plus 2n pi. Or we have that 4x has to equal 7 pi over 4 plus 2n pi. And we have to solve each of these equations for x. Starting with this first one, we see the right-hand side is going to have a common denominator of 4. The right-hand side will equal pi plus 8n pi over 4. The left-hand side is 4x. To solve for x, we need to multiply both sides of the equation by 1/4. And we end up with x is equal to pi plus 8n pi over 16. Now be very careful that you don't make a common error some students make, where they think they can cancel this 4 with this 8. These cannot cancel. That will never happen because the 4 doesn't also go into the other term. Remember, in order to be able to cancel, we would have to be able to factor a 4 out of here and then cancel that 4 with this 4. So these cannot cancel. There's no simplification that can go on. And we just have to multiply straight across, multiply straight across. And one of our solutions then is that x is equal to pi plus 8n pi over 16. Now let's look at the second equation here. Same thing, we want to get a common denominator on that right-hand side. We see that that denominator is going to be 4. So the right-hand side is going to become 7 pi plus 8n pi over 4. The left-hand side is 4x. Now we will multiply both sides by 1/4, and we end up with x is equal to 7 pi plus 8n pi over 16. And that is the other formula which will generate all the possible radian solutions to this equation. In this example, we have to find all the possible radian solutions to this equation, 3 tangent of 5x plus radical 3 is equal to 0. We know that the first step is that we have to isolate the trig function, so we will subtract radical 3 from both sides, and we have 3 tangent of 5x is equal to negative radical 3. Next, we will divide both sides by 3 and get that tangent of 5x is equal to negative radical 3 over 3. We know that when the tangent function is negative, that means our angle has to be in quadrant 2 or 4. Looking at our special angle chart, we go to the tangent row and look up the value of radical 3 over 3, and we find out that our reference angle is equal to pi over 6. Now we put the reference angle in quadrant 2, and we know that starting from pi, if we back up by pi over 6, that means we're subtracting, and this would be 5 pi over 6. In quadrant 4, we put the reference angle there. We would be starting at 2 pi, and we subtract pi over 6, and we are at 11 pi over 6. Now, this is one of those situations where if you notice that 5 pi over 6 and 11 pi over 6 are a distance of pi from each other. Think about it. From 5 pi over 6, you would add 6 pi over 6, which is 1 pi, and you would get 11 pi over 6. So from here to here is a distance of pi. Same thing, going here to here is a distance of pi. So rather than having to solve two different equations where you take 5 pi over 6 and add 2n pi, and you take 11 pi over 6 and add 2n pi, you can instead solve one equation where you take the argument of the function and you set it equal to 5 pi over 6 plus n pi. Notice that this will still generate all of the solutions. We're not skipping any of the solutions. We're starting at 5 pi over 6, and instead of going all the way around with a 2n pi, we are going halfway around with an n pi. So we're starting at 5 pi over 6, and then this says go halfway around, halfway around, halfway around, halfway around. If you wanted to solve two separate equations, this plus 2n pi, this plus 2n pi, that's okay too. But this is less work, so if you understand the relationship between these angles, you can save yourself half of the solving equation work. Okay, so now we're ready to solve this equation. Let's get a common denominator on that right-hand side. We can see that it's going to be 6, so the right-hand side becomes 5 pi plus 6n pi over 6. The left-hand side is 5x. To solve for x, we will multiply both sides by 1/5. And we will end up with x is equal to, once again, be careful on that right-hand side. This 5 will not cancel with this 5 because it won't also go into the 6. So there's no canceling that can happen on the right-hand side. What we do get on the right-hand side is 5 pi plus 6n pi divided by 30. And this is our formula which generates all the infinitely many radian solutions to this equation.